5 News with me, Karen DeMello. Let's have a look at the headlines first.
Margao traders, businessmen and residents march on Margao Municipal Council to protest against exorbitant rise in house, sanitation and garbage tax. Find no one to submit memorandum. Petrol pumps in Goa to go dry on 10th May. Will be shut on Sundays from 14th May and work in single shift on other days if the demands to high commission is not heeded by the oil companies. Drug sales has been stopped in Kalangkote constituency, claims Deputy Speaker Michael Lobo. Says Girish Chodankar has no right to criticize leaders like Manohar Parrikar.
Now the news in detail. Traders, businessmen and residents of Margao march in the Margao Municipal Council to submit a memorandum against the exorbitant and indiscriminate rise in the house, sanitation and garbage tax by the council without taking the public into confidence. However, to their utter surprise, the chairperson, vice chairperson, not even the chief officer was available in their chambers at 11 a.m.
आंग पहिले सीपी ना व्हाईस चेअरपर्सन ना आणि सीओय ना काउन्सिलर ना या इलेक्शन टायमार या खूप नाल फोडपा जाले पहिले सारखे हजर असता व्हाईस पर्सन चेअरपर्सन सगळे हजर असता पण आज तो हांगा ना जाल्यार कोणूच ना आता लोकांनी कोणाक वेट करपाचे आणि इतली इतली हे मेमोरेंडम दिवपा आता कोणाक वेट करपा आम्ही इतली हे गार्बेज टॅक्स लायला पारवाल्या बाबड्यांक खबर सुद्दां ना सुप्रीम कोर्टा ऑर्डर प्रमाणे हे उरतले काय वयतले ते पहिली डिप्रेशनात गेले आहात कित्याक बिझनेस बंद झाला हा टोटल अर्ध्यान तरी बंद केला आणि त्यांचेर गार्बेज फीज लायला ए सी आहात खाय त्यांना 54,000 म्हाका खबर ना ए सी गार्बेज कसली एक्स्ट्रा हे करता तो सो त्या लागून हे जे चल्ला सारखे मनशां लोकां पब्लिकांक मडगांवकारांक फसवण्याचो प्रयत्न करपा चल्ला तो बेगीनच्या बेगीन हे बंद करचे म्युनिसिपाल्टी ना जाल्यार म्युनिसिपाल्टी चड दीस टप्पना म्हाका अशें दिसता.
Savio Cutino, convener of Shadow Council, appealed to the people to cooperate and join the agitation. Cutino said that only 20% commercial establishment has trade licenses. The 80% who don't have it are not on the records of the municipality, will go scot-free.
म्युनिसिपाल्टीन जे रेट्स लायिल्ले आसा जे गार्बेज फीज लायिल्ले आसा ते भयंकर चड जावन आसा आनी लोकांक एफोर्ड जावपा सारके इतले असले रेट घालून आसा तेमी पूण भितर बसून कितेंच रेट घालून लोकांक हे त्रासान घातिल्ले आसा. आज जेन्ना म्युनिसिपाल्टी 12,000, 30,000, 34,000, 54,000 असले जेन्ना रेट लायता तेन्ना मात पण जस्टिफिकेशन आसपाक जाय की हे जे रेट्स लायला ते खरे तांकां हे आसा तितले गार्बेज ते प्रोड्यूस करता काय ना. आज 20% कमर्शियल इस्टेब्लिशमेंटा कडेन ट्रेड लायसन्स आसा 80% खात्रीन सांगता 80% कमर्शियल इस्टेब्लिशमेंटा कडेन ट्रेड लायसन्स ना म्हणटरी तांचो कसलोच रिकॉर्ड ना हांगा सो तांकां 1 रुपया फारीक करपा पडना एज फार एज गार्बेज फीजा कन्सर्न वेरेज जे कोण कायद्यान धंदो करपाक सोदता तांचेरूच हो हे गायल्लो वयता जो बर्डन आसा तो गार्बेज फीजांचो. तेजे भायर कितलेशीं घरां लॉक्ड आसा लोक आमचे भायर आसा शॉप आसा लॉक्ड आसा जावं फ्लॅट्स लॉक्ड आसा पूण तांकांय बी गार्बेज फी घातिल्ले आसा वेरेज कितलीशीं शॉपां आनी घरां जे गार्बेज प्रोड्यूस करतात पूण म्युनिसिपाल्टीच्या रिकॉर्डान ना तांकां कसलोच गार्बेज टॅक्स फावो जायना. तेजे भायर आख्खे मडगांवभर तुमी पळयले जाल्यार डोर टू डोर गार्बेज कलेक्शन म्हणटा जायच ना कांय थोडे पॉकेटांनी डोर टू डोर गार्बेज कलेक्शन जाता आणि तांकां 600 रुपया लायला ते बरे आसा ऑर 1,000 पण ज्या भागांनी गार्बेज डोर टू डोर जायच ना तांकांय बी हो हाय रेट ऑफ गार्बेज कलेक्शन लायिल्लो आसा.
फॉर प्रायम व्हिडिओ जर्नलिस्ट आदित्य बिद्रे मारगांव. Motorists will have to keep close watch on their tanks from 10th May onwards. Petrol pumps in Goa, as with the rest of the country, will go dry for one day, said Narhar Thakur, executive member, Goa Petrol Dealer Association. This isn't a show of solidarity to the oil companies not meeting their demand for a raise in commissions. Briefing the media on the directives received from the national body, Thakur stated that from 14th May onwards, pumps will be shut on Sundays. In addition, they work on single shift from 15th May onwards.
Our long pending demands for commission increase, which are pending with the government, should be taken up. A resolution was passed that since last time the government had assured us that they would have a meeting with all the executive directors of all respective companies and our association leaders, and they would come with a some sort of a settlement whereby we were assured a increase in price commission, rather our commission. But these things have not taken place. So they have decided now that on 10th of May, as a token of strike, or rather to show our solidarity, a one day no purchase would be done, that is on 10th May 2017. And 14th May onwards, every Sunday, we will take off. And 15th May onwards, we will work only in single shift. This was decided, the resolutions have been taken in this meeting.
For Prime Video journalist Sunny Narvekar, Panjim. Deputy Speaker Michael Lobo has said that he has stopped the peddling of drugs in Kalangut constituency. He was addressing a press conference on Tuesday to counter the criticism made by Girish Chodankar, General Secretary Congress, of the felicitations of BJP National Leader Amit Shah and Goa CM Manohar Parrikar. Lobo said that Chodankar had no right to criticize the likes of Parrikar. Addressing questions by the media on drugs, prostitution, casinos and the La Money issue, Lobo stated that prostitution can't be totally stopped as the new people enter the line every time. There should be zero tolerance for the drugs and prostitution, and Goa would be best if promoted as family and couple destination. When questioned about the La Money controversy, Lobo pointed the wrong use of the word La Money and said that they were a tribe for whom he has the utmost respect. The word to use would be hawkers, who should be stopped.
Before I could become MLA, there were drug sales happening in my coastal belt of Kalangut. When I hit it hard on the police and I gave them the names also, those guys were arrested. They are still in the jail. They got released after 3 years. They again got arrested because they were bringing in drugs from some other places and selling it over here. So we have totally stopped sale of drugs in Kalangut constituency, in my constituency. No, no.
But the Nigerian influence is still there in Barra areas, touching Sioli and all that.
These are peddlers. There were sales happening in certain places in Kalangut, from the houses, from the restaurant. This is all stopped. It all depends how effective a person is. The police inspector, the MLA of that constituency, the panchayat, even the people who are who work behind the scene to stop all this illegal trade. So if you work, definitely you can stop. By only saying something, it cannot stop. You know, you must work out a mechanism, identify the places who are doing this trade. Give the names to the Chief Minister, give the names to the Home Minister, to the DGP, Director General, Anti-Narcotics Cell is there. I had given names to even Narcotics Control Bureau. So this is how you can stop it. You have to go deep inside, and definitely law is there to protect you. And I feel if there is anything happening in his constituency, he can stop it. I will help him. We have to correct this word. La Money is a tribe, it's a scheduled tribe. We can call them as hawkers. Hawkers and control, hawkers and stop. And you come to Kalangut, we have removed all of them from the main road. Bichacher thode ha, Azuni Atsuriya business kutta, they are hawkers. And if any tribe is hurt, I would say sorry. Because we respect the Lamanis because they are finally a tribe which is in Goa for many years. Aizodor Goinchi Gora Banle Akupshi. They were the people who have dug the ground. And if Fatur Tasun plaster Kella. So I have already spoken to him over the phone that there was a mistake on his part. What he wanted to say was hawkers and not Lamanis. So I would correct it. And if anybody is hurt, the leaders had come to me also. And I told them that on behalf of the minister, I would apologize. He did not mean to say Lamanis, he meant to say hawkers. Teka te kong na. So ami sagle jan te Lamani Lamani manta te Lamani manan sajmala do. So it is not Lamanis, they are hawkers. We need to stop them. The BJP in Goa, and particularly the felicitation, ja ami felicitation kela, Amit Ji Shah, our national president for BJP, and felicitation of our honorable chief minister Manohar Parrikar. Asa ye khui tori frustration bahir satta congressacha itun sun officean sun ani wo general secretary jo ha tenso he has no right to criticize a person like Manohar Parrikar who has been elected as an MLA 5 times and 4 times chief minister.
For Prime Video, journalist Sunny Narvekar, Panjim. In a case wherein a doctor was assaulted in Carmona by a father and his daughter on Monday, a delegation of doctors along with the president of Indian Medical Association, Dr. Medha Salkar, met the superintendent of police South and demanded immediate action against the duo. Dr. Babu Redkar was assaulted by a father and daughter duo at his clinic at Carmona on Monday. They alleged that the doctor had not attended to the mother of the daughter when they had brought her to the doctor's clinic 3 weeks back when she had suffered a heart attack.
Dr. Babu Redkar, he was assaulted by a lady and her father in his clinic. Now, this is an incident which happened yesterday afternoon. And subsequently, we came to know that this lady, 3 weeks back, this lady's mother, she had suffered a heart attack, and they were participating in Carmona retreat, and immediately the lady and her father, they got the mother to doctor's clinic. Now the doctor's clinic is small, and the doctor rightfully suggested the lady to take her mother to Margaon, to the district hospital, where all the amenities would be there to revive her. Because the doctor, because he had a small clinic, he did not have ventilator facilities or oxygen providing facilities, so rightfully he gave this direction. But the lady insisted that the doctor see her. So by the time the doctor went outside, the lady and her mother, they were gone. They had already left for the other hospital. Now this is the incident. It had happened 3 weeks back. Now yesterday, apparently the lady's mother passed away, and yesterday this lady and her father, they passed into the clinic of Dr. Redkar, and they abused the doctor and gave filthy words. And their accusation was that this doctor did not intervene or save her mother. He could have saved her.
Dr. Medha Salkar, president of IMA, said that the SP assured the doctors of doing justice and had arrested the accused father, and that the daughter was absconding.
Medicare Act, which is in place since 2013, that it will be taken to its full this logical end, and then she will see it personally that she will do justice to it. And she also told us that the male counterpart, that father of the victim, the person who is dead, her husband is already arrested, and the daughter, who was also one of the person who assaulted doctor, is absconding, she said. But she told us that she will issue a lookout circular, and then within 15 days charge sheet will be filed against her.
You know, the warning should go to the, you know, general public and the patient, that you cannot take doctors for granted. If you take doctors for granted, I will be the first person, I tell you, I will be the first person to do maximum things for that particular doctor. I will leave my practice, but I will take it to those patients to the end.
For Prime Video, journalist Aditya Bidre, Margao. In yet another gory accident involving a truck and a two-wheeler at Kone, near Farmaguri Ponda, a woman pillion rider died on the spot and her husband suffered grievous injuries.
Ahmed Sheikh, 46, and his wife Shakila Sheikh, 42, were travelling towards Panjim, was hit by a HP gas truck from behind. While Ahmed was thrown away, Shakila came under the wheels of the truck. It is learned that the couple was proceeding to the Goa Medical College to give lunch tiffin to a ailing relative admitted there. For Prime Video, journalist Sanjay Naik, Ponda.
Well, it's time for a short break. Stay tuned.
This is Infomedia Prime Slot Network, and you're watching Prime. Your voice, your channel.
Welcome back. There are apprehensions that the Gondari Bridge is not safe for vehicular traffic, as the arc of the cable stayed bridge appears to have developed a bend. The illumination work of the bridge has also not been completed, and people complained of antisocial elements ruling the roost in the darkness. However, GSIDC MD Sanjit Rodrigues allayed all the fears of safety and said that the illumination work would also be completed soon.
Rodrigues said that various works are being going on. Road surfacing work is being carried out right from Old Goa to Amona Junction. Widening work has also been completed wherever possible.
As far as electrification is concerned, the work is ongoing. We have completed the work of approach roads. Due to technical reasons, few poles on both the bridges are yet to be erected. We will erect these poles within the next 15 days. We have received reports that there is some inconvenience to motorists due to this trench. We have taken cognizance of this. We have instructed filling up of this trench immediately. Work is going on. By today evening or tomorrow, we should complete filling up of this trench.
Rodrigues allayed the fear of bridge being unsafe and contended that it was safe. He said test reports also have been sought from IIT Chennai. He said the bridge will be open for heavy traffic after the reports are made available. Although heavy vehicles are prohibited from plying over the bridge, it was found that such traffic does not ply on the bridge.
See, there were issues which the consultants had raised on the bridge structure. There were some bracings proposed which were left. We have completed the job of bracings. There is no other apprehension which we have on the bridge. The bridge is safe. We have asked for stability as well as test reports. These third-party testings are going on through the team based at IIT Chennai. We are awaiting these reports so that they confirm that the bracings which are done are as per the design. Apart from that, we have absolutely no other apprehension in mind. The bridge is tested at the highest possible level through our consultants and through third party consultants. We have no structural issue with the bridge at all.
For Prime Video, journalist Sunny Narvekar, Panjim.
Although the expectations are very high, I have taken necessary steps and the responsibility to see that the expectations are fulfilled. Thus opined Govind Gowde, the first time Arts and Culture Minister in the Parrikar government, while speaking exclusively to Prime TV.
Unfolding his vision for his constituency, Gowde said that as farming was the mainstay of his constituency, he would lay emphasis on organic farming, take up the Kulmunkar issue and see that there is a smile on a farmer's face.
As agriculture mantastana, organic farming jauchi oso majo ek vichar jo ashlo to ha mukhar olpa khatir ha mai as prayatna kelo asa ani jo shetkaryak aaj atyant mahatvacho jo vishay jo asa khas karun priyo matadar sanghakadin to nighadit asa to mhanaru kulmunkar jo kaido asa ya sandarbhan sarkaracha pahilyach baithakik prashna upasthit karun हो जो विषय जो आसा तो ताबडतोब सुटावो करून पयले म्हणल्यार शेतकऱ्यांक एक आनंदाचे आणि सुखाचे दीस तांच्या चेहऱ्याचेर पळोवपाचे हांवें एक मुख दवरलेले आसा. आणि शेतकर शेतकार हो आमचो कोणो जावन आसा, हो कोणो टायट कसो उरतलो हेजीच जतनाय आणि जबाबदारी काम करपाचे हांवें ठरवलेले आसा.
Referring to the burning issue of unemployment, Gowdy reminded that even during his campaign time, he had said that giving government jobs all is not possible. However, he would stress on entrepreneurship.
100% सरकारी नोकरी किंवा युवकांचे जे नोकरे संदर्भात जे प्रश्न जे असतात, ज्वलंत प्रश्न असतात, त्या हा सुटावे करपाक शकपाना हे हांव वारंवार प्रत्येक माझ्या जाहीर सभेत सुद्धा सांगतलो. परंतु जे होतकरू जे युवक जे असतात त्या युवका खातीर एंटरप्रेनरशिप ह्या दृष्टिकोनातल्यान आम्ही आधार करपाक शकतात. काही स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्रीज असतात त्या दृष्टिकोनातल्यान प्रयत्न चालू असा. आणि जे इंडस्ट्रियल सेक्टर ऑलरेडी पुणे किंवा ह्या गोंया भितर जो असा, पण म्हाका एक कॉन्फिडंट असा की युवकांचो जो नोकरी पाण्याचो जो प्रश्न जो असा तो हांव तुरंत सोडोवपाक किंवा हांव सोडोवपाक यशस्वी जातलो. आणि त्या दृष्टिकोनातल्यान म्हजे जे जे एचआरस असतात, ह्युमन रिसोर्स मॅनेजर्स असतात प्रत्येक कंपनी कडेन, तांचे कडेन हांव एक संपर्क करून जे जे पोस्ट जे असतात ते आमच्या खास करून प्रियोळच्या भागातले किंवा त्यांना लोकल्सांक दिवचे अशा तरेचे सजेशन्स हांवें थोडे जणां केल्ले असा आणि मुखार हांव करपाचो असा.
As an art and culture minister, Gowdy said that his endeavor is to give the artist appropriate stage, for which he would propose a temple city wherein the artists would be able to exhibit their traditional art to tourists to become self-sufficient. Gowdy said that he would ensure that the Kala Mandir is completely within 2.5 to 3 years. He also said that the Priol bus stand would be ready by 20th May or latest by 18 June.
Lokakala hi atyant gabo jo asa, and to khas karun Mardol Priolan aaj khub so dison yeta. Ani hya drishtikonatlyan ek temple city javchi, jeni karun temple city zalyanantar apli ji lokakala ji asa ती लोककला ह्या ट्युरिस्ट जे येतात किंवा इंडियन ट्युरिस्ट जे असतात ह्यांच्या मुखार ते सादर करून तो होतकरू युवक जो असा, तो कलाकार जो असा, तो आपल्या स्वतःच्या पायाचेर सुद्धा उभो राहून आमची पारंपरा जी पारंपारीक संस्कृती जी असतात ती मुखार व्हरपाक जातले आणि तातूंतल्यान रेव्हेन्यू जनरेट जातलो असो तरेचो म्हजो एक संकल्पना असा.
फॉर प्राईम व्हिडिओ जर्नलिस्ट संजय नाईक, पोंडा.
The High Court, in its recent hearing of the Father Bismarck murder case, has asked the crime branch to register an FIR based on the complaint of Mario Dias on 7 November 2015 and carry out a reinvestigation as quickly as possible. They would have to submit a report every 3 months to the court.
Father Bismarck's murder case, we have won. The victory has embraced us. And the court, honorable court, has given a decision that the crime branch has been asked again to file an FIR based upon the complaint of Mario Dias on 7th of November 2015 and carry out a reinvestigation as quickly and as expeditiously as possible and submit its report every 3 months to the court. This is a great victory for the people of Zua, for the people of Goa, for the friends, disciples and followers of Father Bismarck, and it is a great slap on the face of Lakshmikant Parsekar, on the face of Umesh Gaukar, on the face of Kartik Kashyap, and on the face of Inspector Sinari of Old Goa. All these people have always contended that Father Bismarck died a death due to accidental drowning, which is not the case, and that's why the investigation is taking place, and these people should feel some shame today and regret their actions of past.
Union Minister of Road Transport, Highways and Shipping Nitin Gadkari was all praise for the garbage treatment plant at Saligaon when he visited it on Monday. Gadkari said this was a successful attempt to convert waste into wealth.
Waste into wealth yachatla ha yashashvi prayog me pahala anek prayog baghitle pan yani jya ritine segregate kela aahe sagla tyatun bio fertilizer tayar hota. त्याच्यापासून जनरेटरमधून इलेक्ट्रिसिटी तयार होते. बायो फर्टिलायझरच्या बरोबर अनेक प्रकारच्या वेस्ट रिसायकलिंग होतात. यात व्हॅल्यू ॲडिशन आहे आणि हा प्रोजेक्ट देशातला यशस्वी प्रोजेक्ट झाला मला बघून अतिशय आनंद झाला. कारण आतापर्यंत या क्षेत्रामधले प्रोजेक्ट जवळपास सक्सेस झालेले होते.
त्यामुळे याची कॅपिटल कॉस्ट कमी करणं, इंडिजिनियस मशिनरीमध्ये आणणं आणि याच्यामध्ये अजून व्हॅल्यू रिडक्शन केलं तर हा पूर्ण PPP मोडमध्ये पब्लिक प्रायव्हेट इन्व्हेस्टमेंट व्हायबल होईल. कॉर्पोरेशन आणि राज्य सरकार यात इन्व्हेस्टमेंट करायची गरज पडणार नाही. एवढं चांगलं यातून उत्पन्न निघू शकतं आणि लोकांना रोजगार पण मिळू शकतो.
फॉर प्राईम व्हिडिओ जर्नलिस्ट सुभाष कुटवाळकर, म्हापसा.
Tell us how you like this newscast. WhatsApp is on 9637969244 or email us on newsprimegoa@gmail.com. Well, that's all for the news now. Stay tuned for more news and updates. Till then, keep watching Prime.